Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuhu. May the peace and blessings of Allah, of God, be upon you all. A very quick note for everybody. Allah says in the Quran, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنَ. Do they not reflect upon the Quran, or are there locks on their hearts? If we reflect upon the verse that tells us to reflect upon the Quran, we may conclude that the more we contemplate, meditate, and discover, and analyze, and search for the gems in the Quranic verses, the more our hearts will become unlocked to receive the mercy, guidance, and divine love. Because brothers and sisters and friends, the Quran is an ocean, and we must do tadabbur, reflection and pondering upon this book as Allah tells us. And the more we ponder, we take an ayah, we take a verse, and we find out, what does it mean for me? What does Allah want me to do concerning this verse? How does it affect my spiritual and social DNA? How am I supposed to act and live and behave? How am I supposed to be? Meaning, what kind of state should I be in? So I want to encourage all the brothers and sisters and friends to really engage with the Quran from this perspective, because the Quran wants to be engaged with. Because the Quran was sent down for the whole of humanity, and human beings are thinking human beings. So Allah, the divine reality, the Lord of everything that exists, is telling us, engage with His word, with His eternal word. And I believe if we engage with it and we ponder upon it, we can really find solutions for all of life, but particularly our spiritual life and for our moral and ethical lives. And I just want to give you an example. I want you to go to chapter 12 of the Quran. It has become my favorite chapter. But this is the beauty of the Quran. Every time you understand a chapter, that becomes your favorite chapter. So I've done some work concerning the 12th chapter in the Quran, and I find it so fascinating. Even Allah, God says, is the greatest story. So in this greatest story, I want you to read this story and find out, why did Yaqub alayhi salam, why was he suffering and in distress? Well, we know he was suffering and in distress because Yusuf, his beloved son, alayhi salam, Joseph, upon whom be peace, Binyamin, his other little son, was also missing. And he was in distress. Well, he says in the chapter 12, verse 86, I only complain of my suffering and grief to Allah, and I know from Allah that which you do not know. So from the perspective of a state of being, so say we're depressed sometimes in life and we're really upset, or we don't know where we're going, and we have this kind of existential crisis. Who are we? Whose are we? What are we? Why are we? All these questions we can't really answer properly. We haven't really reflected upon those questions properly, because we all need reminders. So we can be in a state of suffering.